Well, hello everyone, I'm Yanni from BUFU Gaming, and today we are back in Kato. So we arrived at this story chalet last time, and okay, it says first floor. It doesn't seem like we can interact with this book, but over here is something. Destination Desert. There was sand as far as the eye could see. It was inescapable. Between your seats, on your skin, in your sandwiches. When the sandstorms were at the most fierce, whole camps would be buried, routes leading back to the grassland and other neighboring regions would disappear. These paths could be found again by intrepid adventurers, or, at times, unwitting wanderers. Okay, well, it doesn't seem like there's anything down here. Nope, okay, so let's check this one. It's glowing, of course, so it looks like this is where we need to go, but just wanted to check. So, what did it say? Searching the sands. The desert could be a harsh place and was home to a resilient nomadic people. The shifting sands were a way of life, often confounding the flora and fauna. And within the tumult, a wizened woman searching for her granddaughter. Ooh, maybe that's Granny. They had been separated by a storm and yearned to be together. Ah, okay, then we can read again. No, I don't. Nope. Not at the moment, anyway. Okay, it doesn't seem like we can... Well, there's no opening on the left side, so it doesn't seem like we can go over there right now. But we can probably move these things around, right? Okay, well, let's just look at what we can before we start doing that. So we have a second floor here, and that looks like a key or something there, but we can't interact with it. Hey there! Welcome to the writing room. This is where all of our stories are created, though I can't tell you how. It's not a secret. I just don't know. No one does. That thingamajig over there just churns them out and has been for as long as anyone can remember. My job is to tend to the stories, and that's good enough for me. If you'd like to know more about the story chalet, this is the room for it. I keep some of my other favorites here, too. Oh, okay. The enigmatic story chalet. Deep in the forest, in an unmemorable corner, sits the story chalet. This peculiar building can be tricky to find when you're looking for it, but easy to stumble across when you aren't. It houses a remarkable library of books, overseen and catalogued by a storyteller. These mysterious tomes are endlessly updated by an unseen hand, documenting stories and cultures around the world. The building itself is an architectural marvel with a deceptively simple facade that obscures its more sophisticated interior. Okay, so we have an opening here. But yeah, let's try and look around a little bit here. A book lies open on the desk. Nearby, a typewriter taps steadily on its own. Spooky. That is true. Okay. The observers above. Their people served an essential function to chart the lands, noting any changes and shifts over time immemorial. They traveled by airship, quietly observing from high above, rarely disturbing the people below. Their navigation skills were peerless, passed down through the collective memory of their ancestors. Simply, they were cartographers, by trade and by blood. Ooh. Okay, so, I'm kind of wondering if it will change anything. Like, if we get new stories, if I attach this, for instance, up here. Let's just go and check it out. That leads over here. Okay, it doesn't seem like it changed anything, right? We do have a door. Okay, now this door disappeared, of course, because we kind of move things around. So we have a door here, and we have a door there, and then we have an opening over there. Okay. It's interesting. It's kind of when you have it like this, then it shows one door, one... Oh, no. Okay, yeah, I think it shows two doors here. I'm just kind of standing in the way, maybe? Yeah. So we have one door and two doors. And then the bottom left one has like a brighter door in the middle. Okay, well, I guess. Well, it looks like we should be able to walk through here, right? Yeah, we can actually. Haha, there was an opening on both sides. The gathering of magic boots. The grasslanders found endless ways of improving their lives through clever applications of plants. Using an of different rubber plants, they created a new type of footwear. These magic boots could be stretched to fit any sized foot and raise the running speed of its wearers. The last known pair awaits someone bold enough to spot them. Somewhere in the grassland wing of basement 2 of the Stray Shelley. The grassland wing of basement 2. Okay, I'm just gonna note that. So, grassland, and it's basement 2. So, I have a feeling we have to move things around to get to it somehow. Okay, well, let's see. Aha! Yeah, we're gonna want to do that. Oh, but that one is still glowing now, so it's probably gonna keep glowing until we find the boot, right? Let's check out this one. Nomads of the grassland. Nomads by nature, the people of the grassland typically migrate once a generation. They travel to barren lands, bearing seeds and ancient irrigation techniques. The grasslanders are deeply attuned to their flora, listening to the voice of the earth and coaxing its growth through song. By the time the next generation migrates, the land they leave behind is a fertile paradise. Ooh, that's cool. Popular grassland campfire songs. Good night, sleepy sheepy. Sympathy for Red Devils. Ganga style. Ballad of the Sour Potato. Traditional. Begonia Bob. Monka's mournful melody. Hey there, Delilah. Okay, so this one has like, this looks like a grassland carpet, right? What do we have over here? We have like a reddish carpet. Do we have a carpet over here? I'm just wondering if that is, yeah, so that is like a desert carpet, right? So I'm kind of thinking we need this one over here to be a basement one at some point. But for right now, let's try and see if we can figure out how to access this. So if we take you and put you up here, potentially. Yep, then we can go down. Where can we go? Well, these can lead up. And this one can lead up. But it can also lead down, right? So that one would be able to lead down to this one, I think. So if we take you and put you down here. And then... No, okay, that didn't quite work the way I was hoping. I hope that door would lead somewhere, but it did kind of say ding. Okay. So that didn't work. What if we put you over here and then we had this one? That was down there before, right? Okay, so that works. Ah, it's because we have to have the door on this side, right? And then we come up here. So, now this is basement 2. So this is actually where we want the grassland to be. So it doesn't matter which side it's to, but it's basement 2 because we have 3 layers, I think. So this is the top floor now, and then we have 1, 2. So this is basement 2, this layer. Aha, because look at these. Yeah. We got a boots. How was it? W. No? Oh, right, I have to do it here. Magic boots, put some pep in your step, save time, and whisk right over shallow obstacles. Okay, I'm sure we're gonna need that at some point. We also got this Friend of the Forest amulet, a mystical gift from the Watcher. Who knows what it does? But I don't really know how we can use any of... Well, we can use these. We can to read them, right? But I assume at some point we're gonna need these for something. Okay. And see, now it stopped glowing over here, so we got what we needed from that. So let's head back up, and then we are gonna try and go up here. Mm-hmm. The little cartographer. With her fancy new boots, the little cartographer knew that nothing could stop her. She would head out to cross the river and find her way to the desert where she hoped her grandmother waited. So we have to go to the desert. It looks like there's a door down here that might be the one we need to access or exit, right? Even though you'd think it would lead down, but actually the other door behind us leads down. Entrance, first floor. An inky beige liquid. Is that ink? Maybe. Okay, but it doesn't seem like we can do anything with it. Can't do anything over here. Then we have a door here. But before we try the last one, I kind of... would like to see. What if we do this? Just because I'm curious. See, now this is the second floor. Okay, let's have a little chat with him before we try that other door. Nice boots. I didn't notice them when you first arrived. They look like they can get you wherever you need to go. I bet you're eager to get back outside and put those boots to use. Okay. Well, let's try and go here. It might be that you... Okay, now we're out here. Okay, so that just takes us outside. Oh. Then we can potentially cross over here, right? That's why we couldn't... Yeah, now we can get across here. So I guess the boots just work. It's just this one. Save time and wish right over shallow obstacles. Yeah, haha. Okay. Trail to grassland. Return to the grassland. Let's say no for a second here. I guess I would want to go back to the grasslands. This is where we came from, right? We came out from there, from the Watcher, and then we ended up here. But we kind of want to go to the desert. Okay, let's try and visit them at the grasslands first. I assume we can get back here at some point. Or does it lead back to another level? That's the question. But we kind of put the boots to be able to get over here. So let's say yes. Only way to find out. Hopefully we can go back again if we need to. Welcome back, little wood sprite. We were worried when you disappeared. Did you happen to see the ghost lily? No. Well, we kind of did, didn't we? We just gave it to someone. But that's a secret, I guess. Ah, well, I figured I'd ask. Manka will be sad to hear it. I think he was still holding out hope. But everyone will be glad to have you back. Though I know that look in your eye. Are you on your own secret mission now? You're looking for somewhere sandy. I don't know of such a place, but sometimes Mo the shepherd arrives home covered in sand. Maybe Mo knows where Mo goes. He should be with his sheep. Okay, so we need to go to him. No road ahead. Yeah, no. Okay, let's have a little look and see. Okay, well, we have you, and that would be Mo up here. Well, before we start moving anything around, let's just try and head up here. Because I do see the teacher over here. Where did you go? Oh, she is busy teaching again. Welcome back. I'm glad to see you're safe. Perhaps you can regale the students with your travels sometime. Okay. The ghost lily went to the afterlife. I want to be an adventurer like you. Did you find any cool plants? We learned about the pincer puppy. And then we have you. Okay, so let's see. Curved roads to tend. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, we kind of need to go up here. So let's just move that down here. And have a little chat with... Oh, he's sleeping, of course. What? My sheep! Have you seen my sheep? Wait. All of my sheep are here. Why did you wake me up? Where do I get Sandy? Don't tell my dad, but I don't know. Sometimes I just wake up that way. Maybe I can show you when I'm asleep. I'm wide awake now, but there are probably some plants that can knock me out. But I'm no plant expert. If you want to see where I get Sandy, you might have to put me to sleep with some plants. Ooh. Okay. Have we heard anything about... Well, there's these ones, but I don't think they're good. Might have to put... Well, we probably need a plant expert to tell us about that, right? So, let's see. Well, we have the teacher, but... Hello again. Oh, are those new boots? You're certainly making good time in them, but you must be tired from running around so much. Children, what plants can we use to help our friends sleep soundly tonight? I know! Pick me! It's not a competition. Everyone can answer. I think each of the children has something to tell you. When you gather the plants, put them inside this pot. The children are all so knowledgeable about plants. I'm so proud. Dozing daisies! They slowly nod and make everyone around them tired. There are a bunch planted near the circle road. Slumberstalk. Its stems have a gentle fragrance that makes everyone sleepy. It grows in the center of a field of yellow leaves. A field of yellow leaves. Okay, I'm already forgetting what the first one was. Whispergrass. When the wind blows through it, it sounds like a bunch of people going shh. I saw some at the mouth of the river. Okay, so we need a field of yellow leaves and we need the mouth of the river. And this was near the circle road, right? The circle road. But I'm thinking that's not even near here, that is somewhere else. Even though I'm thinking about the place with the owl, right? But that is somewhere completely different. Don't have anything else on this map, right? Okay, the mouth of the river. Let's head down here. So we can start moving the map around, but for now, let's not do it. Okay, so we have something here, but that's not really the leaves that are... yellow. Maybe Mo knows where Mo goes. Okay, you don't have anything new to say. Well, the mouth of the river, I would think that was where that was over here. Right, the head of the river is up there. Okay, so we're gonna have to figure that out. That would be when it leads into the ocean, wouldn't it? Like, well, we can't put that there. Okay, so that's not an option. Oh, it was an option. Aha. Ooh, good thing I put it there. okay, so, oh, here we go. Okay, so now we got that one. Let's have a little look-see on the other side. Yeah, there's just more of them. has. So it was actually because the mouth of the river, right, leads out into the ocean, of course. Yes, yes, yes. Well, there was the plants with the yellow, but I would still say yellow flowers, but there were the ones over by the house. But then the house was kind of in the middle, so I'm not quite sure about that. Let's go down here. See now. No, it was down by this one here, wasn't it? See, these ones are the ones I'm thinking about. A planter that smells strongly of caramel. Yeah. Teacher always knows best. Center of yellow leaved. Well, it could also be these ones. They are yellow leaved, right? So maybe those would be something to mess around with. Okay, if I put you here. And there. But we only have... Oh, like this? Okay. Yep. Yep, we got another one. Okay, and then it was the circle road. Let's grab you. But we don't really have like a circle road, do we? What if I move you down here? And but that doesn't really help, does it? This is gonna turn into such a mess. You can almost make a circle. Let's put you up here for now. Oh, this is turning into such a mess. Ah, there we go. Okay, so it made the last piece. Yes, yes, yes. Because the only circle I could think about was the one we made with the owl, right? But here we go. Must be these ones. Ah, okay. We have all three of them now. And now I've made a complete mess. But this teacher is down here. The children are also knowledgeable. Okay, so... But now we have all three of them. Okay, maybe we have to give him all... No. We had to put it in the pot. Right? Didn't she say to put... Okay, we have... Whenever the wind blows, you hear it. Shh. Everything smells so sleepy. They nod so... sleepily. Okay, well, let's try and go up here. Maybe we just have to give them to Mo. Wide awake. Flowers for me and the sheep. How thoughtful. More flowers. Are you really? Spoiling us. There we go. Now he fell asleep again. Oh. Oh, and all the sheep are actually following him. Here we go. Okay, well, we made it over here. Would you like some more tea, Penelope? Just wanted to see if these have... Nope, they don't really have anything special to say. Okay, let's check out. Okay, we're all the way over here. Yep. Okay, we can't interact with this. That looks like a crystal. So let's just go in here. Ooh, achievement unlocked. Quick learner. Okay, I guess we completed some chapter then. Ouch! What a terrible idea. Ouch, an even worse idea. Why do you keep touching them? I don't know. Just because that's fun. Okay. Oh, wow. Okay, well, let's see if there's anything up here. Mm-hmm. It doesn't seem like we can interact with any of these. Okay. Cactuses have thorns. Thorns are sharp. Oh. Oh, achievement unlocked. Not so sharp. You've learned nothing about these plants. Stop touching them. Okay, well, I got an achievement. You've learned nothing. Okay, now just keep saying the same thing. Then it might not be so interesting to... Nope. Okay, I'm gonna stop touching them then, I guess. Here we go. But you guys know me. Anything I can interact with or read or anything has to be explored. Yeah, it just keeps saying the same thing. Okay, so now it's not so much fun anymore. Okay, nothing else down here. Let's check this out before we check out the map. Oh, look at these guys. I love your goggles. When did I get so old? You'd better believe I'm sharp as a cactus, but my body feels like an ancient temple these days. Sandy and full of skeletons. Enjoy it while you can, kiddo. Beautiful, isn't she? This golden desert of ours. Curves as far as the eye can see. Ha! We used to have a lush oasis all to ourselves, but it dried right up. We've been searching for another water source ever since. Ooh, that sounds like something we have to fix. Some equipment and supplies dusted with sand. The cacti may look dry, but we squeeze every last drop of water out of them. Ouch! Phew! You must be parched, young sister. I wish we had more to offer you. We're down to our last few cacti, and Granny Nua is looking a bit worse for wear. I'm fine. Yes, yes, of course you are. We were barely able to set up this camp in time before the sandstorms rolled in. The rest of our unit headed west across the yellow sands. Are you familiar with our desert? Be careful in the yellow sands. They're ever shifting, and the landscape around you can change in a heartbeat. The white sands around us are calm. You can always use them to find your way back. If you brave the yellow sands, keep heading west to find the rest of our sisters. If you do, please tell them we haven't seen the captain yet. She's a strong woman, but this sort of thirst can break even the strongest of us. Head west across the yellow sands, we won't be far behind. Okay, oh look at this cutie. Such steadfast mounts, our boys. They're able to conserve water in their bodies, the clever things. It makes them too heavy to cross the yellow sands, but it's helpful to have extra water around just in case. It's a good thing we found those cacti when we did. Aww, that's so cute. Okay, so the yellow sands, and now we have gotten even more yellow sands. Well, if we want to head west, then we do have to go this way. Here we go. So let's place these over here. And then we are gonna be exploring those next time, guys. So yeah, thank you for watching. And as always, do take care and happy gaming.